everyone. My name's Sabrina, and I'm so glad you're here today in our big backyard. I was just about to check in with one of my bug friends. Let me just give him a call.
Hello? Oh, hey.
Hey, Daisy. I want to introduce you to my friends.
Oh, hey, everybody. How are you doing?
We're doing great. How are you?
I'm doing great. Just a teeny bit tired. I didn't really sleep a lot last night.
Oh, no. Why didn't you sleep well?
Okay, well, see, the thing is, I'm scared of the dark.
What? We couldn't really hear you.
I said I'm scared of the dark. You see, I know I really shouldn't be afraid of the dark. I know in my brain that there's nothing to be afraid of. The exact same things that are in the room when the light is on are the same things that are in the room when the light is off. But every night after prayers, Mom tucks me in, she gives me a night-night kiss, and turns off the light. And that's when I start to feel super alone, and I start to get afraid, and I don't like it. I just don't know what to do. I can't not sleep forever. I'm gonna be so tired.
Aw, Daisy, I'm sorry you're so sleepy. But I'm sure you'll be able to take a good nap today. And I think I might have something that will help you not feel so alone. You see, I was just getting ready to tell the boys and girls about three friends who also might have felt alone and pretty afraid. We can read all about the three friends in my favorite book. Do you know what my favorite book is? That's right, the Bible. And the Bible's important because it helps us know how much God loves us. The three friends' names were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now, the coolest thing about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego is that they loved God. They knew God cared about them, and He would always be with them, and He would help them whenever they needed help. And because they knew God was their good friend, they obeyed God no matter what. The three friends lived a long time ago when a king named King Nebuchadnezzar was in charge. King Nebuchadnezzar? That's a big name. Nebuchadnezzar. Wow. King Nebuchadnezzar did not believe that God cared about him. He didn't believe that God was always with him. And he didn't believe that God would help him whenever he needed help. He didn't believe that God was his good friend. King Nebuchadnezzar built a huge statue made of gold and told everyone that the statue was more important than God. But wait, that's not all he did. He also made a bad rule. He told all of the people in the land that they had to bow down and worship and pray to the statue. What? We don't worship statues, do we? No, we worship the one true God. Then he said, whoever didn't bow down and worship and pray to the gold statue would be thrown in a fiery furnace. A fiery furnace is like a great big fire that's very hot. Oh, what were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego going to do? They knew that God was their good friend and that he was the only one that they were to bow down and worship and pray to. So when everyone else was bowing down to the big gold statue, they did not. That made the king really mad. He was so mad that he made the fire even hotter. And then he threw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the fiery furnace. Whoa! They may have been really afraid, but they knew that God was their good friend. When the king looked into the furnace, he couldn't believe what he saw. They weren't hurt at all. They were just walking around. The king didn't know how this was possible, but it was true. Then the king looked again, and he didn't just see Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the furnace. He saw a fourth person. There was another person walking around in there with them. God made sure that they weren't alone because God is a good friend, and he wanted to make sure they were safe. The king shouted at them to come out of the fiery furnace. And guess what? They came out and their clothes were not burned, and they didn't even smell like smoke. The king knew that God kept Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego safe in the fire. The three friends knew that God was their good friend, and they knew God would always be with them, even in a fiery furnace. They knew they were never alone because God was their good friend. So you see, Daisy, God was always with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He was such a good friend to them.
Whoa! God was a good friend. He was with them the whole time. They were never even alone.
That's right. And God is always with you too. He'll be with you when you're at home or on vacation, when you're scared or you're happy, when the lights are on or when it gets dark. He's always with us, and we don't have to be afraid because God is a good friend. Who's a good friend?
God is a good friend. Thanks for giving me a call. I think I'm gonna go take a nap now. Bye, friends.
Aw, sweet dreams, Daisy. Bye. I'm so glad that God is always with us, just like he was with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And we can ask God to help us because he's our good friend. Let's all pray and thank God for being such a good friend. If you're ready to pray, give me a big clap. Dear God, thank you for always being with us, and thank you for being our good friend. We love you, God. Amen.
Clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands, everybody. Clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands now. Clap your hands and listen up. Everybody, it's time to jump. God's a friend, no matter.